necessarily further, that give us a good athletic balance, okay? Our weight is on the balls of our feet, okay? If our weight's on our toes, and what happens? Someone puts you in a ball, or back like this, all over, okay? If I have more of this, then just one, I will demonstrate it on the board. So, weight on the ball of our feet, okay? Shoulder width apart. Give us a nice athletic balance. Knees, toes. Okay? Next comes our stick. Stick is always in front of our hands. Hands are equivalent to each other.
Than what I just showed you, go ahead and show me it. Okay.
Try shuffling.
There's a puck right here. It's gonna come straight into that glass.
We open our glove like this. Physics chance to hit the heel of it, hit here, bounce it out, okay? We always want to project that glove angle, all right?
Other than that, just straighten out your stick in the middle there. Hey, perfect. And we're good to go. One thing, a little nitpicky, watch that overlap with your pads, okay? So, what? If you can, okay? So, you can overlap when you know it's going to be a low shot, okay, and the shooter releases it. This is what I would call a passive stance, okay, where you're kind of relaxed, like that, exactly, okay? But a reactionary stance is once someone shoots the puck, then you get lower, feet get wider, okay? You know where the puck's going. But we have to be careful about that because shooters these days are good where they can make a toe drag or a snap shot and change the angle on that shot, right? So we can't get too wide in our reactionary stance to where we can't make an adjustment like a shuffle. Something like that. Okay? Make sense? Cool. And let's quickly just do butterfly, okay?
Butterfly. No. Good. Butterflies with the same thing as the stance. Same butterfly. Okay? Same thing as your stance. Once again, project that glove angle. Good.
Guess we'll ask this. No, that looks good. I like good flare there. I like everything about that. Okay? Awesome. Let's get into some foundational skating. Okay? Well, one more thing about the butterfly. Make sure chest is over the top. Okay? When you're going down, chest over the top. Reason why is that brings your head forward, okay? And it causes your butt not to go down like this, okay? In your butterfly. When our butt is like this, we can't see our hands, okay? Or we can just with our peripheral vision. But we don't want that. We want to be able to see it with our eyes like that. And also our stick. Okay? Good stuff. All right. Let's do just a little bit of skating. I won't kill you. It's a little bit of skating. Any questions?
No.
Pretty basic stuff so far.
Same one I used for every single one of my boards. Okay, whether they're somewhere, student years, college, whatever. We always start with some hands. And then you start with the right leg isolated, same. Okay, so our left hand stays the same.
When's the last time you got those skates sharpened?
Like a month ago. I feel like they're still sharp.
What do you get them at?
I don't know, I'm like trying things. I don't remember which one it was.
I would get either a half inch or 3/8. So, now that I can tell that you're a little bit more advanced, during these speed cut drills, we want to aim for efficiency, okay? Because when, especially back C-cuts, because when do we use C-cuts moving back from what kind of place? Like breakaways, 2-on-1, okay? You know what I'm saying? Back flow. So, it's really just two strong cuts, okay? But they're efficient cuts. So it's like this. Got it.
Good, dude, good.
So I'll see you that time.
Instead of in the middle, okay? We want everything at this point, all our weight. to be distributed right into the middle, okay? Now our lower half.
Yeah, so power is generated just for one leg. This leg is also bent and stabilized, okay? So, just a short C cut. And I don't care at all, Ben, again, if it's fast or slow.
I'd rather see you do it right, okay? Same thing. Backwards, 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 my bad. Ready? Go! Good. Make sure you find that puck. Find that puck. Okay. Ready? Go.
Yeah.
somewhere in the middle. So, if a shot comes, let's say a shot comes here. Here, there's a guy out there. It's low to high. I leave my stick. I have to bring my stick back in the middle, and then he takes a one timer or something. That leaves us exposed, okay? So leaving our head in the first thing. Okay? Keep digging.
Good. Take a look. Good. That's one. Best one. Nice.
Need one?
Take some. Take some.
Okay, same thing but backwards, so watch me. This is where taking the look really is important, okay? The look rotate. Reset. Take a look, rotate. Got it, reset. Stick's always in the middle. Take the look, rotate. Got it, reset. Take a look, rotate. Reset. Okay? Moving backwards. Moving backwards. Get that stick back to the middle. There you go.
So the double shuffle is replacing the T-push. Why is that, do you think?
Two shuffles without a stop. This is two shuffles without a stop. Two different.
Just the red line, just the red line. Come. So a couple things I noticed there is one. Just up to three. Then I'll get you some water. You can do it on the goal line so I can get the camera. Ready? Go! One this way, one this way, two that way, two that way, okay? Two this way. Sorry. Let's reset, okay? So it's one, one, two, two, three, three. Got it? My bad. Not your fault. Ready? One. One. Two. You're good. And I'll keep you frustrated. What's the best one that I've done?
2 days ago.
So, just scrolling around.
Yeah.
Okay. Look. Are you on the ice often?
I don't know about you looking at it.
First 10 or so are gonna be down low. Okay? First 10 or so are gonna be down low.
Thank you. Do two more high exercises.
So, another reason why we're taking shots from the outside here. Is because most of the shots we're taking in the game are from outside. Okay? Drink. We want to see. So this is what's called a clear-sighted shot. Okay. You probably already know this. Clear-sighted shots are shots where a goalie has more than half a second to react, okay? And there's no obstruction. What I mean by obstruction is there's no traffic, there's no tips, there's no pass options, okay? The only option is me shooting. Therefore, our depth, we want to be right about here, okay? The back of our stick
touching the top of the crease, okay? Back of our CH touching the top of the crease. And the reason for that is best goalie in the NHL at these types of shots, clear set of shots, is Braden Holtby. He's 6'3". He stands right about here, okay? So it would make sense. I'm not 6'3", you're not 6'3". It would make sense for us to stand where he's standing, right? Because he's the best in the world at it, okay? Best in the world at these types of shots. So, when I make the move, we want to utilize that short shuffle, okay? Short shuffle like that. One more to go. You only get two up angle. You don't want to use a T push. Okay? Just want to use a shuffle. Make sure you know your bearings. Okay? After every rep, I recommend you tap your pulse, get on angle, okay? With the next shot or the next puck. Okay? Questions? And if you disagree with me on anything, let me know, because I'm open to disagreements. And no goalie coach, no matter what they say, knows everything. Okay? So, if you have any questions, feel free to ask, okay? Like why I'm doing something the way I'm doing it.
Right here.
Ready?
Turn here.
So we can talk. Yeah, grab your water. Take a knee. This will take a sec.
Reverse vertical horizontal. Okay. This is a blocking save, not a reaction save. Okay. This is why goalies overuse it and get beat so many times. Okay? Because they think it's a reaction save, not a blocking save. Alright? So, first off, that's determining when we should go into the RPH. Okay? I'm going to draw a little triangle. Okay. So first, we're going to measure about two stick lengths. Okay. One, two. What size paddle is that?
23.
26.
That's what this is.
Actually, you're not, okay?
if you put a camera here with a puck, there's really no room to shoot. Okay. Secondly, you seal the ice, okay, without leaning one direction or the other. Does that make sense? You can say it if it doesn't make sense.
We go down into a butterfly,
okay? Both sides, okay? Our weight is evenly distributed. One side we're kind of leaning against the post, okay? This we're not. The only drawback, and this is where the RVH is better, is for our wrap plays, okay? Where someone's wrapping around the neck, okay? So if I overlap and a guy decides to come around, okay, what we'd have to do is find the post, go post the post, and then go into an RVH or whatever if he tries to jam it as he wraps around. All right? So, why don't you try the RVH? Questions on it? Okay. So, good.
You have to do this 1,000 times, rep-wise. say you can't be good at it. But all I'm saying is there are alternative solutions to what you do. Okay? I do like the idea of sofa bumping out. Okay, bumping out, fancy term, you're pushing to the middle. Okay? First shot. Okay? Don't worry about your pattern. So it's really good for bumping out, okay? And remember, when we're bumping out,
always, always, always angle
before gap. So you get on an angle, then we can adjust for a gap. That makes sense? Okay. Do you want to take some shots on the RPH, or would you rather do the other way?
That works with me. You have to make the decision of whether to go down with the RVH, VH,
which VH.
You asked for it. I say.
Thank you.